When the revolution succeeded and Mubarak stepped down, the Muslim brothers very quickly and cleverly wove deep relations with the military council, which controlled the country and the state. They proved to be one of the main players on the Egyptian scene after the revolution. They declared their attitude towards women, democracy, Christians, secularism, and they consider both women and Christians as second great citizens, as both are to be denied the post of the head of state or posts in the cabinet. These posts, according to the Muslim Brothers' reading of Sharia, the Islamic law, should be reserved to Muslim men. All the Egyptian laws before and after the revolution are civil laws, except for the family law, which is based on Sharia, on the Islamic law. On the Islamic law, as they read it, it has been historically used as a tool by the patriarchy to control women. The family law had been issued at the beginning of the 20th century and amended several times, but usually the amendments were partial, meaning that it never went deeper, the amendments never went deeper to the legal ground, which is based on Sharia. In Sharia, women are awra. Awra, it means a sort of shame. In the reading, in the Muslim, modern Muslim reading, common reading of the Sharia, women are awra. All the cities joined the revolution. When Mubarak was toppled down, on the 11th of February, there were 20 million Egyptians in the streets and the squares all over the country. This sign of success made them join not because they are for the regime. No, of course, they are not for the regime because they were all the time in prisons and so on. But because they are not the initiators, they are not the organizers. And this is very important in their intellectual mentality. If they are not the leaders and the organizers and the initiators, they will not join.